Don't Doubt Your Horses, a participatory exhibit. Info at swmnarts.org or call 800-622-5284. I'm an artist and writer from the prairie land of southwest Minnesota. For several decades, I've been asking friends, acquaintances, and strangers, could you please draw me a horse?
Came back. I thought you were going to run away from the horse drawing.
Us?
Yeah. Oh. I overheard you say you want to draw a horse.
Yeah, they changed their mind. Just a little bit of time to process it. So that's
fantastic. I'm so glad.
Yeah. I like your booth setup. It's cute.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Do you bring it to other fans?
A lot of dino drawings, but not as many
horses,
so it's fun.
Yeah, I'm so glad. I've got a gigantic horse drawing collection from people. Because I've been asking people just randomly for about 30.
That's just for special.
That's a great horse.
I like your horse, Cole.
You want some brown on your horse?
Do you wrestle with John Stern? John Stern is your coach?
No. He used to coach college with my husband,
oh,
with their
dad.
Yeah.
Yo,
but now it's just Elijah.
But you're
Elijah
doing paper
wrestles
machine.
For SMC. Yeah.
That's what's
what is
bad.
That here in town? What is that?
You want to take it? Oh, you're waiting for the book?
You draw your horse.
I want to draw that.
Violet and Murray, do you want to draw a horse?
That's okay.
Yeah? You do?
Okay.
I'll grab you a picture.
Just fine.
People have an open invitation here in the library to come and sit down and draw a horse and then take it home with you or add it to the exhibit, which most people do. But some people just want to take their horse home. And a lot of people, of course, are too shy to draw a horse in the first place. If I'm around, I can kind of encourage people to do it anyway. And then some people draw a horse and just don't want to share it with
anyone.
Except me. They want you to see the horse. They want you to like their horse. But they don't want everybody to see the horse. So there's a little box here that says, anyone can see my horse. And I just leave that as an open check so I can use these for publicity purposes. You know, if people don't check a box, you know, no big deal if they check the box and leave it. But there's also a box that says, my horse is for Dan's eyes only. and then only I get to see those horses. I have an antique safe deposit box in my studio. I have the key, and that's where I keep them. Nobody sees them. And also, sometimes people start a horse and throw it away. They go in the box. I keep them.
Don't Doubt Your Horses is a public participatory exhibition that includes your drawings with mine. It has been in development for 7+ years, beginning with the 400 Horses Project. Born from a desire to understand the equine body structure, the 400 Horses Project began as a drawing exercise. I set out to create 400 horse drawings from January 1st to December 31st, 2015. All was going well until I got blocked a few months into the project. I journaled and meditated and drew my way through the artist's block. Then came a truly unexpected idea. I discovered that the project was not about making horse drawings. It was about liking the horse drawings. If the project was to be completed at all, I would have to accept all the horses. Every drawing, every horse. This was much easier said than done. The shift of focus from the act of drawing to the act of liking necessitated a deeper appreciation for the horses themselves. In order to accept them, I had to let them be who they were, who they are. This approach to the project began raising essential questions about standards and aesthetics. What is bad art? What drawings would artists hide in their sketchbooks? What horses would be crumpled up and thrown away? In the end, it seemed right to include every single drawing in one exhibition. The phrase, "Don't Doubt Your Horses," emerged along with some of the more adventuresome horses who were harder to like. I repeated the phrase to myself. Without that mantra, some of these horses might never have come into being. I acknowledge the Dakota peoples on whose land we meet. I thank them and their relatives for the care of the land, and I recognize their continuing connection to the land, waters, and community. I pay my respects to them and their culture, both past and present. Hey, thanks for supporting Southwest Minnesota Arts Council's gallery exhibits, and thanks for supporting local artists. Yay! Marshall-Lyon County hours are Monday through Friday, 10 a.m. to 8, and Saturday, 9 a.m. to 2. If you have questions about the location, please contact the library at 507-537-7003 or library at marshalllyonlibrary.org. Lyon is spelled L-Y-O-N.